Nothing like a little vomit in the car.
Is this the first time a dog's vomited in the car?
Today, yeah. It's about the 472,000th time that it's happened.
I'm always on the case, trying to figure out what the hell happened to him.
This guy's lived his entire life chained to a tire in a yard with nothing but hatred being thrown at him. Of course he's going to be nervous and throw up.
When you say Vic's dogs, you mean Michael motherfucking Vick.
It is exactly the dogs I'm talking about. The dogs that he admitted killing in a federal court. The dogs that he admitted drowning. The dogs that he admitted slamming against concrete are these dogs' relatives. Yes, and they survive. And like a phoenix rising from the ashes, rebirth them into beautiful animals.
I named him Machiavelli after Tupac because of the adversities that Tupac overcame in his life.
Motherfuckers can't stop me, even if I die.
I hope Machiavelli can become the rose that grows out of the concrete, too.
Tupac was an artist. Tupac was a workaholic.
Don't run out of breath, every step could be death to your blast.
Tupac created a world around himself. He spent a lot of time in jail. Grew beyond all of that. He created himself and then recreated himself.
Full of niggas goes by. Thought I was tripping the second time they rolled by.
And continues after death to recreate himself. The man is a legend. He's an inspiration. He created a world in rap and in hip-hop that no one else did. Tupac transcends race. Tupac transcends time. Tupac died and is still changing lives. And in that sense, his art will live forever. And there was a very arrogant, very aware of his power.
To my fucking block.
I think that's reflected in a lot of the things he did, being crazy.
Time to be a ghost.
Waving guns around, flashing all the money, being all fucked up. I can relate to that.
And there will be ghosts. Don't cry, just ask why.
The Brandon Bond that the media created was in some ways very similar. This shit's on fire. This song right here, hit him up. Come on, like he's just straight inciting hatred. But at the same time, cultivating hope. How can you do that as an artist? How can you tear down and rebuild in one fucking piece of art, in one painting, in one lyric? And you know, it's like, what's some white tattooed boy, you know, listening to Tupac? Tupac was also the underdog. He was the first rapper to be heavily tattooed. He did make us as tattooers an awful lot of money. So thanks, Tupac. Appreciate it, man. And his back piece, that cross, fuck, I've done that 8,000 times on people. Everybody wants the Tupac cross and the AK right here, you know? Tupac did influence the tattoo industry in a tremendous way. And any tattoo artist that's a piece of shit or a racist or whatever can't lie. You know you did a Tupac cross before. Don't talk shit. Don't hate the player, hate the game, man.